welcome to a new day of in the 10-day DIY challenge. We are on day 9 of the 10-day DIY challenge, and we're slowly going close to the finish line tomorrow. So today's recipe that I'm going to be showing you today is for a DIY tooth powder. Now, tooth powders are something that have been used by most of us, you know, probably in our younger ages, and it has been used by our previous generations, like our grannies, our mothers, etc. But over a period of time, tooth powders were phased out and toothpastes took over. Now, toothpastes were introduced for their convenience, for their ease of use, you know, for that jelly texture that we see in toothpaste. But they're also filled with a lot of unwanted ingredients, like, you know, glycerin, and it has things like fluoride, which are not required for us, and even more bad for our kids. So the commercial toothpaste nowadays are extremely toxic, and this is something that we put into our mouth. So you can imagine how much, you know, how much, we don't really know how much gets washed out, how much really remains, etc. So you don't know how much you swallow even without meaning to. So that is one thing. So this is one reason why, you know, it is always good to go for something natural. The other thing is, toothpaste tubes generally are not recyclable. So, you know, when you start using toothpaste and when it gets over, there is nothing you can do with a toothpaste tube, and it will just go into the landfill and lie there indefinitely. So, this is actually one more reason why, you know, this making your own tooth powder at home is a great way to start your eco-friendly journey and the best way to go plastic free. So today's recipe is a very, very special recipe. It's something very close to my heart, because I've worked long on this recipe, and you know, I've tried to find different ways to make this work. And so let's quickly go ahead and see the recipe. Now for this recipe, first of all, you know, we have like a combination of ingredients, and I'll be running you through all of this. But then finally at the end of the day, you can just play around with these ingredients and use as much as you want or as little as you want. So the first ingredient we need is our rock salt. Now I use rock salt for my cooking purposes also. This is better than processed salt. So I just have this here. We need about 2 tablespoons of this Himalayan pink rock salt, or just plain rock salt. So we need about 2 tablespoons of that. The next ingredient we need are cloves. Now if you can see, this is clove. I'm sure a lot of you know. So cloves, we need about 10 cloves. So 10 cloves powdered down, which will be around 3/4 of a teaspoon. So cloves, basically what they do is they give you that fresh feeling in the mouth, and I'm sure a lot of you must have used cloves when you have any kind of tooth problem or tooth pain, etc. So basically cloves are great for, you know, your oral health. So that is the reason we're using cloves. And of course the salt is for remineralizing your teeth and for maintaining your teeth in a clean way. So basically for cleaning the teeth. So that was the use of the salt. The next ingredient we need are mint leaves. Now mint leaves, what you can do is you can buy fresh mint leaves and then dry it. So you can shade dry it, and then you can powder that down and put it into this tooth powder. So mint leaves, you need about 1 tablespoon. So 1 tablespoon of mint leaves, 2 tablespoons of salt, about 10 cloves powdered down, and then you need a pinch of turmeric powder. So turmeric powder basically is more for the teeth whitening property that it has. I know it's a little surprising, because turmeric is yellow in color, and it is surprising that it can actually whiten your teeth, but it can. So that is the reason we're using turmeric powder. We'll be using about 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder. And then the last and final ingredient is the activated charcoal powder. Now this activated charcoal powder is optional. You can use it if you have it. If you don't have it, you can completely skip it. It's fine. You can just, you know, stick with the other ingredients and then play around with the recipes, play around with the ratios, and make your tooth powder. Now the mint, what it does is it gives you a very fresh feeling. Generally when we eat mint, it is like a mouth freshener, right? So it's like, you know, it gives you that fresh feeling. So that is the reason we are adding mint into this recipe. Now unfortunately I don't have fresh mint, or rather mint leaves, in hand. So I'm going to be adding peppermint essential oil. So this is another option. In case you don't have mint, you can add even peppermint, you can even add the essential oil of mint. So all you need to do now is add all of this into a mixie jar. So we start with the cloves first, because that is a little harder to break down. So you first add the cloves, and then you run the mixie, and then you add in the mint leaves, and then the salt, and then of course the rest of the ingredients. So this mixture, this tooth powder that you get, can later you can just use it as is, you know, as is, just like a tooth powder, or you can use it with a little bit of coconut oil. Now coconut oil is great for your oral hygiene. So I don't know if you all have heard of oil pulling. So oil pulling is a technique where you first thing in the morning you gargle oil in your mouth. So basically you put oil in your mouth and you gargle, so as to maintain your mouth's good bacteria and maintain a good oral hygiene. So it's for the same reason that we be using coconut oil in this recipe. Again, that is optional. If you want to, you can use it along with the powder and then use it so that you make it more like a paste. So this is all that needs to be done. I am going to do the step of running the mixie and then making the powder after this video is done. So I will be putting it in the comments later on. So do check it out. And in case you are a person who's been on the fence about, you know, using toothpaste, not sure whether if it is the right choice for you, for your kids, etc., I would say please do try this out. It is a great recipe and it works wonders. As you can see, it is all completely natural. So do try it out. And also, as I mentioned, it is great for kids. So you can use for your kids also. Just make sure that the clove is a little lesser, because clove can get a little, sting. It can sting a little. So just make sure about that. But other than that, it is a great recipe. So do try it out. And I'll meet you tomorrow with a new recipe. And it'll in fact be the last of our recipes. So I'll see you tomorrow. Thanks for watching with me. Bye.